Good afternoon, all. Thank you for having me. My name is John Ogbeme, and I'll be presenting the title titled Digital Manufacturing System Paradigm for the Manufacturing Robotics of Bogie Frame and the other frames using robotic methodology. Now, the motivation for this work came up when I visited the factory, and I was able to engage, maintenance engineer. When he asked me, you know, what is your line of research? I told him, I'm working on robotics, especially in the area of the welding of very complex joints, because currently in literature, we don't have a system for welding of the bogie frame, of the bogie frame structure, because it has a lot of shapes because of the configuration.
If you have the K joint,
yeah, K and T joint, yeah.
Frame, which is a K joint, Y joint, it's
yeah. Now, so this is just a big background of, the rail transport infrastructure is, a very key component in the sustainability of economic development. Railways are seen as very low alternative to air road transport, and even in some countries, it's seen as, the chief mode of transportation. Now, the bogie frame and the body shell are very key components of the rail wagon manufacturing. Now, for some of us who have not seen a bogie frame before, this is how it looks like. It is a structure that the shell sits on. So these are some of the components of the bogie frame. It's actually a welded steel box with structures forming two sections, into a required shape. It's actually a structural member that supports, the body of the wagon. But I'm not going to dwell on this. So these are some of the parts. Now, this is what my research is all about. Now, in rail manufacturing, the welding process of the bogie frame, and the train coaches is usually made up of hundreds of complex welded joints and components, which are known as, the TYK configuration. Now, the parts to be welded constitute a very large size and the complex geometry that needs to be joined along a curved path. The welding process of the bogie frame in the railway manufacturing is usually executed manually. But in Europe, we still have some human-assisted robots. You still have human beings working in between. It is very, very expensive. Even if you have a human welder, that is supposed to work on this bogie frame, is very expensive because the structure is not like what you have in the car, in your Volkswagen, and it's a very complex structure, and it requires a lot of expertise on the operator side. So this is the bogie frame, and I want to see how. But if I introduce robotics into some of these structures, you need to also look at the concept of digital manufacturing. Now, digital manufacturing is a term used to describe the use of integrated computer-based system comprising of simulation, your 3D visualization, analytics, and various collaborative tools to create a product and a manufacturing process definition simultaneously. It's also part of the industry 4.0. DM evolved from manufacturing initiatives such as your manufacturability, your computer integrated manufacturing, flexible manufacturing, lean manufacturing, and even your reconfigurable manufacturing. DM can help manufacturing firms improve their productivity in both manufacturing planning and production processes. Because if we have to be competitive, if we have to compete with the Europeans in terms of delivery, in terms of quality, we really need to embrace this technique. Now, these are the few benefits of digital manufacturing. It enables product, process, plant, and resource information to be linked, viewed through change process with consistent and comprehensive approach in the design. It enables part manufacturing process to be optimized within a managed environment. The simulation capabilities of DM helps reduce commissioning costs by validating the robotics and automation program virtually. So what it means now is that you can start your project in a virtual environment, finish it up, then you also do your commissioning virtually without actually doing your construction and doing your real life commissioning. So you can test your model from the start to the finish, doing all your commissioning and see if it will work. If it doesn't work, then you go back to your analysis, go back to your model, go back to your calculations here. With DM, you can create a factory model faster and ensure that they are operating under optimum layout, material flow, and throughput before production wrap up. The good thing about DM is that it supports Six Sigma and all other lean initiative by providing a graphical environment to analyze dimensional variation. It also facilitates sharing of quality data across the organization by generating verifiable card-based machine inspection programs for coordinated measuring machines. For example, the electrical engineers, the thermodynamics guys can be working on a document, a card file, simultaneously.
Two minutes.
So this is just the framework I'm proposing for both the shell and you have the boogie frame on this side, then you have the other shell, within the digital framework. Now, of course, the design involves design for speed, comfort, as main consideration, just like the last presenter mentioned when she talked about agronomics. So you have your detailed design where you do your structural analysis, where you have your software such as ANSYS, where you will now import your design, then you now subject them to various stresses, crash test performance and the rest. So the same thing applies to your body shell, where you do your body part processes, you automate the system to produce various parts. Then of course you do your welding. The welding there indicates your conventional, because of course you still need the manual welders. But for this very complex joint, you also have the automated welding robot for producing large body elements. Of course, we also have your body shell assembly, side and end body installation, front and end and the rest of that. Of course, you also have your printing and fitting installation, where your robot can also come in. Because it's unhealthy for the human being to be inhaling this these chemicals. Even when you cover, these things are not too good because it has a lot of health hazard. You can check our paper, Obome and Upof. So for details of that. So you can even your electrical installation. Of course, we still have a lot of those ones can be done manually. The robots will not just take the jobs. So these are also for the bogey frame. The other slide was for the shell. So you have your welding, which has to be done. It's programmed. That is the stage where I am in my work now. I'm doing the programming. So your machining too. Of course, you also need your robots too can also come in if we have to be productive. Now, of course, your assembly, where you have your completed bogey. It's not transferred for your quality assurance stage. Of course, you have your finishing. Now, in your test and trials, I'm going to introduce you to some very good tools that will also help us. Because the rail industry is a very big industry, you know. I don't think it would be very expensive to do this, your cast testing crash, what they call car crashing test. You can't do that with the rail because it's a million of runs. So, but there's some software in which you, by the time you do your design, you import it. I'm going to show you some of this software. You do your analysis, you do your crash test, you do your simulation to see if this thing will work. Now, digital manufacturing tools for rail manufacturing. Now, this is a very state-of-the-art software or tool. It is called VI-Rail. It is a specialized railway simulation software from V-Grade. It enables engineers to quickly build a complete parameterized model of a new railway vehicle easily. You can easily define the suspension, wheel sets, and other components. You can also run a series of simulation trials to see if your design will work before wasting a lot of money in actually building the prototype. Now, V-Rail users can instantly see the effect of design changes in a rail car performance in high-speed animation. They can also detect component interference, excessive wear, instability, and performance limitation. Now, these are some of the applications, you know, dynamic simulations and the rest. Now, we also have the flow EFD. It's a 3D computational fluid dynamics analysis, you know. It's a very useful software for the thermodynamics engineers who are experts, you know. The good thing about the software is that it's a CAD format. So another state of the art. It works with some of this software, your NX, Solid Edge, and the rest. It tightly integrates with Inventor also. So that is just it. So it assists engineers conduct upfront concurrent computational fluid dynamics analysis using familiar MCAD interface. This reduces design times by order of magnitude when compared to traditional methods. Now, so it also allows optimization of product performance and reliability while reducing physical prototyping and development costs. So when you use this, you actually, you know, you're saving a lot of money. So this is the screenshots of some of the software. So you also have the pattern. This one is like your console multiphysics for doing your structural analysis. When you import it, you test for stresses and see where you can predict failures, you know, of these models before the actual conduction. So these are some of the capabilities: direct access to CAD geometry, advanced geometry creation, editing, and the rest, post-processing and reporting tools for easy and result evaluation. So this is, I'm actually working with this now, currently, because I'm currently through with my model now, with my formulation, so I'm trying to program this. This software has actually been used for car manufacturing, but we're trying to see how we can use it for the bogie and the other shell. So it has a lot of key capabilities.